kao di hafal berdiri Bu Brock Vibrant. Who we are here this afternoon to pay you traditional homage. We are here in Sokoto State for our National Executive Council meeting and the constitutional provision for us to host a National Executive Council meeting every 3 months. And we give the hosting right to Sokoto State, and we are happy that we are here. As part of our advocacy and constructive engagement, we feel very, very much that we need to come and pay you the homage, being the leader of Sokoto State, having been the former Speaker of the House of Representatives. We are very happy to be here. We know that you're a friend of Nigeria because we have done a medical outreach with you previously. Usually we meet to deliberate on issues of health in Nigeria. We are the custodians of the health of Nigerians, and it is only appropriate that we meet from time to time to deliberate and see, look at the issues and see what solutions we can offer to us and to government and other partners so that the health indices of Nigerians can improve. Because we are very, very keen, as you know, Your Excellency, the year 2020 is one of the worst years in the whole world with the COVID-19 coronavirus pandemic. All the indices, all the socioeconomic circumstances, health indices, economic circumstances have actually been in disarray since February 2020. And at the immigration desk in Abuja, one of them said, "Are you going also?" I said, "No, I'm not going also. I'm going for a conference and I'll come back." He said, "Because when it's taking places, many doctors leave this country, and this is not a lie. If many on a daily basis, many doctors leave this country. And why are doctors leaving the country? That is the question that we must ask ourselves and find solutions." We know that mobility of labor is guaranteed in international labor law, but the way and manner we are moving is not healthy for Nigeria. The doctors in Nigeria are not enough, but many doctors now move to where? Move to the US, move to Europe, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, seeking for greener pasture. And one of the reasons, we'll give those three reasons. One is the poor remuneration of Nigerian health workers, particularly in Nigerian health. Two, the hostile work environment is a big problem with dilapidated, antiquated equipment. And the doctor, by his training, must be learning and updating his knowledge and skill on a regular basis. But what we have here, we have antiquated equipment. Nobody would want to stay and rot away and be all obligated. So people leave Nigeria for that. And the third reason, very important reason, is the issue of the security. The issue of the security is real. And many of our colleagues have been kidnapped. Some have been killed by bandits. And the doctors are not the only one. Many Nigerians have experienced this. And once you are kidnapped and you are released alive, the next point is the airport. You are out. Because your children must have education, you must be alive to train your family. So these are very serious matters, Your Excellency. And we think that the government is keeping quiet for people. Because this is real. If you do not have doctors and other health workers in this country, in fact, where they are going to, they don't need them as much as they do in Nigeria. We have one of the worst health diseases in the whole world. And nothing is being done to ameliorate this. I was saying this to yourself and just now that doctors are paid 5,000 naira as hazard allowance. And we all know that we face the risks of hazard of in our profession. When Ebola came, Nigerian doctors faced it squarely. and doctors and other health workers, and you see that we made history, and we show the world that we can do it, given the right political, environment, and of course, what we call the effective coordination, and then of course commitment of health workers. And we saw how you were a speaker at the House of Representatives then, Your Excellency, and within a very short time, we were able to contain Ebola. That means we can do it, given the right environment, conducive environment. So we want to use this opportunity to appeal to the ESCO, the government, federal, state, local government, philanthropists, and partners to come and support Nigeria. Nigeria needs, the health of Nigerians need to be uplifted. And we can do this through dialogue and consultation and roundtable discussion. Otherwise, we are sitting on a time bomb.
The representative of the Chairman House Committee on Health, who is our own, Honorable Dr. Olade Kakali, the Health Service Chief of Staff, Mr. President of the Nigerian Medical Association, and members of the esteemed National Officers of the Association, members of the executive of the local chapter of the Nigerian Medical Association, Sokoto, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to you all. We cannot express how happy we are as a people and as a government on receiving you today on this very auspicious courtesy visit. When the Public Secretary was making his introductions, I took note of the fact that many of you are from different parts and states of our country. And with the bad news out there, the Sokoto is challenged in terms of insecurity. And the general security situation of the country, it is only when someone is committed to his country that he can do what you have done. Leave your comfort zones and head for areas where, on a daily basis, the needs are not so good. It underscores your belief in the oneness of our country and the need for all of us to see this country as ours, wherever we may come from. On this note, once again, on behalf of the government and people of Sokoto State, I welcome you to the seat of the Caliphate. Your remark, you have indicated that you've been to the Palace of Resemblance. I'm sure it must have given you the totality of the hospitality of the people of Sokoto, because I'm sure Resemblance must have received you very warmly. So we're merely complimenting what our Royal Father and spiritual leader has done. Bringing this pilgrimage to Sokoto is not the first time. You've been here, I believe, when the committee address was also president of the NNA. I cannot remember whether this is the second or third or fourth in the history of NNA that you're coming to Sokoto, but under this regime, this should be the second time, right?
Yes.
So you are taking a second dose of the jab. You gave us the first visit when I was doing my first term in 2016, and now you're here during my second term. From that time to now, as you must have been briefed, I'm sure, by the Honorable Commissioner for Health, and even Honorable Dr. Olade Kakali, Shuni, the story of our healthcare service has improved. For the first time, this is where a national tertiary institution in, at the level of University of Oxford had an MOU with the federal government and the same Ousmane Dafoe University of Oxford to unleash members of the personnel, the professionals in that institution on our own health facilities, where they visit and they attend to patients at our facilities that are not federal facilities. That was the first model of that MOU. And ever since, we've been investing seriously as a government in healthcare and the health of our people. No investment in health can be said to be too much, because without a healthy society, you cannot achieve anything. So health first before any other one. We believe in that principle in Sokoto State, and that's why we've gradually been improving on our funding, not only statutory budgetary allocation, but funding of releasing funds to the health sector in the state. Professor, I cannot agree less with you on the issues you've raised, the four of them. Issue of brain drain should be a source of concern to everyone, even here locally. We have issues of brain drain, for example, from state facilities to federal facilities, because of disparity in remuneration. So it's real. And the earlier governments come to terms with it at various levels, engage with stakeholders, and see how best we can address it, the better for the society. The issue of work environment, we have been improving in Sokoto State on working environment of our medical personnel. We continue to refurbish and innovate and provide equipment to various medical facilities that we have in the state. And we're even building more, many more general stores. We are almost out of the local government headquarters where each of them is having a general store. We are now moving even major centers, community centers, towns that are not headquarters of local government, and building more and upgrading more PHCs to general stores. We are building more PHCs and dispensaries. We are supplying drugs and other medicaments to our facilities, and a number of the drugs we supply are being given to our people for free. And we are also keeping them, because you need the tool. You need the personnel, the qualified personnel, the equipment for you to administer qualitative healthcare on your people. So I agree with you that there's the need for us to really address the issue of brain drain in medical sector and some other sectors too that are very key to national growth and development of our country.